you've been carrying all your life is gone.
Exactly. And go ahead.
Let me ask you this question about I was pursued online by a gentleman, and but in his profile he's like, I'm married. So I'm like, and I'm married, and
you were pursued, but how were you pursued specifically? When what do you mean pursued by?
It was on somebody kept on hitting me up online.
Okay.
Messaging me online.
But were they saying things to you that were explicit, or were they just?
Oh yeah, it's like, oh, I think you're cute. You have a nice smile. You know, I would like to have sex. You know, that the whole pursuit thing. And that was okay. You know, I don't mind. You know,
and they say they're married.
But in the profile, it said they were married. So I wanted, you know, inquiring minds wanted to know. So I'm like, well, your profile says you're married. So what? Not only that he was married, that my wife knows and she's okay with it.
Oh, really?
What's that about? Because my thing is, if she knows and she's okay with it, then let her go find somebody who can love her 100%. You know? And so when I wrote that back to him, he's like, he called me I think he called me a judgmental sissy or something. Mm-mm. I'm like, no, that doesn't, again, that doesn't make sense. Y'all are not telling something. You know, this is not true. What you're doing is not true. And I said, I'm not getting caught up in your drama.
Well, it's not, well, look, I mean, how much does she know? You don't know how much she knows and doesn't know. You don't know what she knows, does know. I mean, she may not really know what she says she knows.
Oh, but from the way he said it, you know, she's participated and they have this. So I'm like, that, I'm not doing that.
Oh, you mean like a three-way?
I don't know to this thing. He never said three-way, but there's been some participation. So I guess watching, and maybe it gets her off. She like, oh, I know exactly what it was. She liked to see her husband be submissive to a man because it made her horny.
Uh-huh. And so is he into it too, or is he just...
Yeah, because okay. He was the one that I'm like, this is too much. You need to let her go. You know, I'm a judgmental sissy.
Well,
like,
look, oh. I mean, this is how I look at it. I mean, look, first of all, he's trying to rope you into his sex thing with his wife, I guess, and trying to get you to have sex with him so she can watch, I guess. Or was he trying to just have sex with you personally, or do you not know the difference?
Oh, I think he was probably just trying to, because he's hit me up, like, even after that conversation, you know, hey, stranger, well, my, hi, you know, stop talking to me. You know, I'm done with that, because that happened to me once in Atlanta as well. You know, I met this guy, we did the do, and then, like, he calls me maybe about 2 weeks later. He says, oh, my girlfriend's here. I think you should come over. No, I'm not. No, y'all are not going to slit my throat when I come to your house. That's not going to happen. You know, so, God, I feel like the biggest whore on the planet right now. But so that to me is bizarre, because like I've told you before, I dated a married guy for almost 3 years. We were in a relationship. Mm. And then it came to the point to where when his wife, and she knew, because it had happened before from her own, for her telling me herself. And when she found out that he was doing it again, you know, it was like, we're going to get you. You're a stalker, and that's what we're going to put out there.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
And then the judge was like, yeah, no, you're crazy. Y'all are crazy. Y'all going to leave this man alone. You know, stop this. You know, and that's one thing. I think I shared it on one of my shows, I believe. And I was like, when that happened, it was like I could no longer be ashamed of who, not that I was ashamed, I was scared to be who I really was,
right?
Even though I knew it on every level except publicly. And then after all that happened, I was drug out of the closet. I was like, okay. And then I should have learned my lesson messing with married gay men married to women, because they're all psycho.
Yeah, well, obviously they've got issues.
You know, I'm crazy enough by myself. I don't need no help.
Well, I mean, that's what I would say. I think it's sad that people do that at all. I mean, like, this guy that hit on you or whatever, and his wife's into this kinky stuff. I mean, if that's what they're into, that's fine. If someone else is into it, aware of it from the beginning, and that's something they're into too, fine. That's whatever you're into, whatever gets you off, fine. But if you are not into that or interested in it, then there's really no reason for you to continue to talk to the guy. Obviously, he's, you know,
No, I'm not doing that. I'm not. You're not watching me. It's not. It's not a live sex show. We're not the Hustler's Ball. Trust. Oh, we're God. Not doing that. This girl don't do that. I can't. I just can't with that. And thing is, it's not the. And thing is, it's not like you're really attractive to me.
Right.
You know, because I've seen some gray teeth in your mouth from one of your pictures. So
Anyhow. No. I know how you are about the teeth.
It's so funny. And this is a quick sidebar. I went to Halloween Comic Fest today. I took my nephew this morning.
Yeah.
And the thing is, they was all being shady. I had an okay time, but it wasn't fun like Free Comic Book Day back in May. But anyhow, and the guy that was the nicest, he was kind of like, not that he was really following me, but I turn around and he has his cell phone in my face. Look at all this artwork that I've done. I look at this man's mouth. When I tell you he had one tooth in his head and it was rotten, I damn near ran out the door screaming. I mean, the thing is, and so after I see it, I don't know if you ever do this. After I seen it, that's all I could do is look at his mouth.
Right.
He had great artwork and he's a good artist, but after I seen that mouth, I could not take, my eyes was glued on that tooth.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
I'm horrible, dude. Right?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, that should nothing to do with the guy's art. I mean, if you like his art, I mean, come on.
If you're such an artist, you need to design some dentures and put them in your mouth because I can't stand. Because my thing is, people are not going to take you seriously.
Well, most artists, though, are too poor to afford dental work. Dental work is very expensive. That's what they call them, starving artists. Most artists, real artists, are not that well off unless they're extremely famous, which really rarely happens. But that happens, but not very often. But yeah, they usually can't afford that kind of stuff. I'm sure you can afford it. I'm sure he can't afford it. So,
but nobody buying nothing from him, so maybe that's what it was. But I just had to throw that in there because I said about the boy's teeth, and I seen some of the worst teeth. But this is the Midwest, and you see a lot of bad teeth around here.
Well, come on. I live in Texas. Give me a break. Come on.
Oh, I thought Texans had really nice teeth because there's a lot of people with money down there.
It depends on where you are. I mean, I see tons of people. I saw, am I going to say who, but I saw this man today that, somebody that we know knows. Anyway, it's a long story, but I'll tell you about it off the loud fire. But anyway, he has no teeth from the, you know, the two bicuspids or whatever, the ones that surround your four front teeth, you know what? Yes. I mean, okay, between there's nothing there. Both bicuspids and all four teeth are gone on the bottom. So every time he would talk, nice guy, but I just could not look at him in the mouth because every time he just saw these two teeth sticking out on the other side of his mouth and that was it. So yeah, I've seen people like that in other parts too. But my point is, people, like, if you go towards East Texas or more rural parts of Texas or rural parts of any part of Texas, Dallas, Houston, Austin, wherever, the rural parts have people like, you know, or Ozarka people or Ozarks people, I mean, you know?
So I guess Texas is really a big state, isn't it?
See, people from outside of Texas don't realize how fucking big Texas really is. Well,
I just get, when you said that, you said rural, and I'm like, okay, in my mind's eye, I'm like, oh, Texas is a really big state. That's kind of dawned on me.
It takes to get from Dallas to the border of Mexico, it takes 9 to 12 hours, something like that.
Get out.
Now, am I kidding you? Yes. And so, and that's not even the top of Texas. The top of Texas would be the Panhandle. So from the Panhandle to Brownsville, which is the border of Texas, the tip of Texas, at Mexico, would be probably 14 hours or so. Yeah. So it's a fucking huge state. And that's just one way. If you go from El Paso to the other side towards Louisiana, it takes a little less time, but, or maybe longer, I can't remember. But anyway, yeah, it's fucking huge. So people don't remember that it is so big. And there's all kinds of people here. And it depends on where you live, in what city, and in what area of that city. It's just big. So yes, there's people like that here too. Absolutely. Abso-fucking-lutely. Yes.
Okay. I just thought I was special because you see a lot of it in Georgia, because Georgia is right next to Alabama.
Well, that's the kind of people you get in East Texas. Okay. You see what I mean?
Yeah. I can't handle it. I'm sorry. That's one of my biggest flaws, is somebody's teeth. And I used to say, and this is how crazy I am, because I am a little crazy, I'm like, if your teeth is not as pretty as mine, I'm not going to date you. That's horrible, right?
Yeah. Well, I don't think it's – I mean, look, I mean, that's a personal preference, a sexual preference. That's different. But, I mean, I would not talk to somebody because they – like, be friends with them or something. However, I also wouldn't want to be going –
to some really nice function with them if they were missing all their teeth either.
Exactly. You can't take them nowhere.
No, it's not anywhere. It's just certain places. I take them to McDonald's or, you know,
But you've seen all kinds of McDonald's is just like the Walmart people on YouTube. You can see just about anything in there as well. I have a really quick thing to say, too, about what we were talking about earlier. I'm sorry.
No, why? That's what we're here for.
This person that I've been talking to, he just actually texted me.
Just now.
This is what it's 2 o'clock in the morning, and he texts me like, and he knows I work to midnight, and he was getting off at 9 o'clock tonight, and he was like, "So what are you doing after work?"
This is the guy that contacted you with the wife and all that shit.
No. This is somebody else.
Oh, this is somebody locally.
It's leading up to a question.
Okay.
And I've been knowing this person for years. We made out years ago in the bar, in the local gay bar, and it's a good kissing or anything. And one of my friends is like, not tonight. So it never happened, you know. And then I moved to Atlanta, and then he found out I'm back in town. So, you know, we exchanged numbers on Facebook, of course. And I think I've seen him once. But I'm on this website, and I need to be off this website because there's nothing but trouble. He has a profile, and now this person, and this is a good question for you. I don't know, you might not feel this way, but I'm going to ask you anyhow. I know he's biracial, and not that he looks biracial, because to me he does. I think you can tell somebody who has a mixed ethnic background.
Does he predominantly look black or white or Hispanic or what? What is he mixed
with? I don't think he's black and white.
Okay.
His father's black.
If you saw him, would you say he's black, or would you say he was something else? If you didn't know,
you wouldn't know he had black in him, but you knew he was mixed with something.
Okay.
But he's very brown.
Mm-hmm.
He's not beige. He's brown.
Okay.
But in his profile online, I think I've talked to you about this before. He says that he's white.
Oh, really? Okay.
And I want to tell. No, I asked him once. I'm like, I said, oh, I didn't really know who you was online because your picture's not there, and it said you were white. Mm-hmm. And then he has the nerve to tell me that. The reason he says white because he looks more white when he doesn't.
Okay. This is a great conversational topic, and I'm so glad you brought it up, and I want to talk about this. I'm going to take a break, come back so we can talk about it, okay? Because I definitely want to talk about this. This is a wonderful topic, and I want to talk about it. So hang on for 4 minutes, okay? I'll be right back, okay?
Different ways. How about you? Could you hear me?